Grandmaster Bela Khotenashvili scored a big win against Jules Moussard in round 6 of the Gibraltar Masters. She joins us in our studio. Bela, a win with the white pieces today against Jules. Happy with the result, but also the quality of the game?
Yeah, of course I'm happy with the result, but after 20 moves, I was very angry about myself that I lost. I spent a lot of time. I had only 2 minutes. Left after 20 moves, but...
So you had only 2 minutes for the next 20
moves. Yes. Fortunately, the position was easy to find some good moves, I guess, after we got this end game. So...
Why did you take so much time in the opening? Were you out of preparation or what happened?
Yeah, I forgot everything after G4. I could not remember the variation. So I started to play some... solid, I guess.
You took 35 minutes at this moment.
Yeah.
And then you went for a very committal d5 here.
Here I was calculating bishop b5. Example, just castle. And then if I take on c6, b takes c6, queen d3, and queen d7, and I did not like this position because after e4, even takes and then rook b8. And so
it's difficult for white to create any play here.
Yeah, these two bishops are very strong.
Right.
So instead of here,
So here Jules played knight e5.
Knight e5, yes, and I played knight e6 to make some.
Yeah.
I don't know. I could not find anything better.
But also this pawn on e6 could be a weakness at some point, right?
Yeah, but if queen c8, then I can take on e5 and the bishop c4 to protect the e6 pawn.
Right.
So he played c6, and here I took e5 and...
You traded the queens?
Yes, and e4. Yeah.
Well, how were you evaluating this endgame for you? Did you feel you were doing fine? You were better. How did you see this position?
About equal.
About equal.
Yes.
Right. And the idea of e4 was just to make sure this bishop gets blocked for the rest of the game. Now, the game proceeded quite in a balanced way from here. Black seemed to be doing fine. You had your chances. What happened at the end?
At the end, I don't know. After rook a3 here, I think rook f8 was a bit more... I don't know what's the idea. Here I played rook h4, and I mean g3 was better to keep this pawn on g3. So
were you planning to play rook g4 or
maybe first take and then
right?
But then bishop f6.
And the bishop comes to g5 and then take on e6. After this. White seems to be doing fine now.
Yes.
So all your problems are solved. In fact, did you think that now you actually could have had some chances here or still a balanced position?
Yeah, I thought that I had some good chances here. Of course, it should be close to draw, but anyway, I have some slight advantage.
And then Black completely collapsed after King F1, Rook D2, a blunder?
Yeah. It's a terrible blunder.
Right, he could have just gone rook d1 check and then...
Yeah, rook d1 check, king g2, and then bishop f4, and I could not improve my position.
So just show us why this rook d2 is such a horrible blunder. So now you just...
And bishop d3 and...
And the point is that if he goes rook d1 check, you go king g2 and you're just running with the pawn. It's a beautiful tactic at the end.
Yeah.
Were you surprised when you played rook d2?
Yeah.
Did you see this idea instantly?
Yeah. I was thinking about rook first to check and the bishop f4 to avoid this variation. But when he played rook d2, of course, I was happy.
And this is around the 40th move, so you must not have had so much time on the clock.
Yeah, but he had about 15 minutes. That's why I was so surprised.
All right, well, congratulations on this win and 4.5 out of 6 going into the second half of the tournament. How do you feel about the way you've been playing so far?
I think I'm good position now. So I hope that these last four rounds will be successful for me.
You're one of the top contenders right now for the top women prize. Is that something you're thinking about, or is it too early still?
You know, I'm trying not to think about it.
Well, that's
just
good.
To play my games.
That's good advice, and we wish you all the best for the remaining rounds, and
Thank
we
you.
Hope to have you back with us.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bela.